Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.1, Problem 10. This is Section 5.1, Problem 10. It says, how much interest is earned on $25,000 invested at 6% compounded monthly for 18 years? Now, if you've tried the previous problem, it's almost the same. It's $25,000 invested at 6% simple interest for 18 years. Same starting amount. Same interest rate, same number of years. The difference between number 9 and number 10, number 9 has simple interest and number 10 has compound interest. And we'll see how much of a difference that makes. So because this one mentions that how frequently the money is compounded, it's telling me I need to use the compound interest formula as opposed to the simple interest formula. So I'm going to start with the compound interest formula. A equals P times 1 plus R over M in parentheses to the M times T power. Then I'll fill that in. So A, the final amount, is the unknown, so I'll leave that as just A, a variable. P is the initial investment or principal, which is $25,000, so that's going to be what I start with, and then times some parentheses. In the parentheses, I have 1 plus R, the rate as a decimal, so again, 6% is my rate, and as a decimal, that would be written 0.06. over M, M is the number of times compounded per year. Now this problem has monthly compounding, so the M will be 12 months per year. And I close the parentheses now, I make an exponent of M times T to complete filling out the formula. Again, M is 12 for monthly compounding. And T is 18, because the question says 18 years. So, now, I have to do the work in parentheses first. Any type of math, when you have parentheses, that needs to be dealt with first. So I'm going to have A equals 25,000 times the parentheses. And now in the parentheses, there's a division and an addition. I have to do the division first. That's just the way the rule works. So 0.06 over 12 is 0.005. So I have 1 plus 0.005 in parentheses. Now, I do that reduction pretty easily without a calculator. If you don't feel comfortable with that, where that's coming from, just take your calculator, do 0.06, the top of the fraction, divide by 12, the denominator of the fraction equals, and the calculator will tell you it's 0.005. Some calculators have a really weird notation. They'll write something like 5 minus 3, something like that. All that is telling you is the decimal gets pulled back 3 places. If your calculator does that, when you add the plus 1, it's going to just write it more in a normal notation of 1.005 to finish your parentheses. Now there's still a 25,000 multiplied times the parentheses, and the parentheses still have an exponent of 12 times 18, which I think comes out to 216. I just verify that with the calculator just to make sure before I go too far. I don't want to go too far with a mistake. It is 216. So, now what I have is A equals 25,000 times parentheses of 1.005 raised to the exponent of 216. So, before I can multiply the 25,000 times the parentheses, I have to raise the parentheses to the 216th power, which again, you definitely don't want to do without a calculator. And it's not 1.005 times 216, it's 1.005 times 1.005 times 1.005, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, 216 times. So, easy with a calculator, not easy without one. So, with my calculator, I want to enter the base of 1.005. I'll press my exponent button, which looks like x to the y power, and then I'll put in the exponent of 216, and then I'll hit equals, and it'll tell me the answer. On some other calculators, what you want to do is enter the base of 1.005. And some brands of calculator, the exponent button looks like an arrow that points up, and you still enter the exponent next, and then press equals. So, with my calculator, I'll clear the screen, put in 1.005, the base, hit my exponent button, put in the exponent of 216, hit equals, and now my formula is A equals 25,000 times the result of that exponent of 216th power is 2.936 7, 6, 5972. And I'm just going to leave that on the screen of the calculator with all the decimals in it. And I'm going to multiply the result on the screen of my calculator times the 25,000 that I had written in front of the parentheses. And when I do that, I'll tell you the result. So the number on the screen now times the 25,000 that was multiplied times the parentheses. And the answer I get is 73419.1493. Now, because this answer is in terms of money, I don't want to have four places after the decimal. It's too many. With money, you go to two places after the decimal. It tells you how many cents. So the 1493 is enough to make it 15 cents. So my answer is going to be 73419.15. So $73,419.15. Now again, that's not the answer. The question didn't say what's the total amount in the account after 18 years, because that's what the answer I have here of 73,000 is telling me. The question said how much interest. So we initially put in 25,000. I have to subtract that 25 away from the final amount in the account. So to finish this problem, you have to take the total amount in the account, which is $73,419.15, and to figure out how much interest you earned, you have to pull away the 25,000 that you put in as principal. So that should be 48,000, but since the 73,419 is on my calculator, let me just make absolutely sure. So minus 25,000 is, yeah, sure enough, it is what I expected. It's $48,419.15. That's the interest that you earned, plus the 25 that you put in gave you a total of 73. Now to compare this to problem number 9, the previous one, the amount of interest that you earned at 6% simple interest was only 27,000. So when you go to compound an interest, instead of 27,000, you're making $48,000 of interest. That compounding makes a big, big difference.